Debbie and Andrew. I'd like to share with you first off that tradition holds the reason why a bride stands left of her groom is so that the sword arm was free to protect her at all times. Andrew, I encourage you that you would protect Debbie, not only physically, but spiritually, and always lead her in the ways of the Lord Jesus Christ. Andrew, it's been said that a woman came out of a man's rib, not from his feet to be walked on, but under his arm to be protected, and next to his heart to be loved.
Two hearts can come together and love can last forever. But now that I have found you, I believe that a miracle has come when God sends a perfect one. Now gone are all my questions about why, and I've never been so sure of anything in my life. Oh, I wonder what God was thinking when he created you. I wonder if he knew everything I would need, because he made all my dreams come true. When God made you, he must have been thinking about me.
From this moment, life has begun. From this moment, you are the one. Right beside you is where I belong. From this moment on, from this moment, I have been blessed. I live only for your
true. Me cry.
Debbie and Andrew. I'd like to share with you first off that tradition holds the reason why a bride stands left of her groom is so that the sword arm was free to protect her at all times. Andrew, I encourage you that you would protect Debbie, not only physically, but spiritually, and always lead her in the ways of the Lord Jesus Christ. Andrew, it's been said that a woman came out of a man's rib, not from his feet to be walked on, but under his arm to be protected, and next to his heart to be loved. Andrew and Debbie, we recognize that it's God is the one that instituted marriage, and we learn that truth in the book of Genesis chapter 2. It was God that said it's not good that a man should be alone. And God, in his timing, he brought Eve to Adam, and Adam rejoiced and said, oh, this is bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. Today, Andrew, God loves you so much, and he's bringing Debbie to you. And may you always rejoice. And rejoice in the giver of the gift. Rejoice in God. He blessed you so much. For God says it's not good that man should be alone. And then his timing, he made it perfect and beautiful to bring Debbie to you. Praise God for that. God is the one that instituted marriage. And know this, God is the one that gives the instructions for marriage. In our world today, there's a lot of opinions on what a husband should be and what a wife should be. I encourage you that you would go to God's word to learn what a godly husband should be and a godly wife should be. And you follow the ways of the Lord and his word, he'll bless you abundantly. And the power of the Holy Spirit will help you live out God's instructions. God did give instructions for marriage. The husbands are commanded to love their wife and to dwell with them with understanding, and one day present her to the Lord, holy and without blemish. The wives are commanded to respect their husband and follow his godly leadership in the home as he follows the Lord. Debbie, know this, you have influence. May your life and your love be the inspiration that will constantly lead Andrew to a greater dependence upon the Lord Jesus Christ to lead you. Well, at this time, you'll be making your vows before God and to each other and in front of your family and friends. Are you ready to do so? Will you please join hands? Andrew, will you please repeat this vow to your bride, Debbie? I, Andrew, take you, Debbie, to be my wife. To have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until we are separated by death. As God is my witness, I give you my vow. Debbie, please repeat this vow to Andrew. I, Debbie, take you, Andrew, to be my husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until we're separated by death. As God is my witness, I give you my vow. Now, will you both seal this promise by the giving and the receiving of a ring? Yes. Rings, please. Andrew and Debbie, these rings, it's more than a symbol of marriage. It's the seal to the vows that you just shared with each other. I do pray when you look at these rings daily that they'll remind you of this day and the vows that you shared to each other. I pray when you look at these rings that you will ask the Holy Spirit of God that he will empower you to fulfill those vows and to live as a godly husband and a godly wife. Andrew, will you take Debbie's rings and repeat after me, please? With this ring, Debbie, I seal my promise to be your faithful and loving husband, as God is my witness. Go ahead and put the ring on. Debbie, will you please take Andrew's ring? Repeat after me. Did you? With this ring, Andrew, I seal my promise to be your faithful and loving wife, as God is my witness. I do encourage you both to ask the Lord to enable you to fulfill that promise as you seal that promise today by the giving and receiving ring. Would you please face me? We're going to be celebrating communion. And we're going to be lighting the unity candle. Andrew and Debbie, in communion, we remember that Christ came to die for our sins and to give us hope and provide the strength that we need. Because in every marriage, we do need God's strength, because marriage involves two fallen, sinful people coming from two separate backgrounds, living in a sinful world. And because of that, we need God's mercy and we need God to help us. So I pray that you would look to the Lord and look to when you have communion and you think about the death of Jesus, not only the death of Jesus, the resurrection of Jesus. And as you have communion, that you remember through Christ's power, you can do all things. God would never ask you to do something that he wouldn't enable you to fulfill. And he wants you to have a godly marriage. So what we're going to do first, I'm going to read from the scriptures about marriage. And Andrew, I'm going to have you serve your bride. And before you serve your bride, I'm going to ask you to do something, please. I'm going to ask you if you would just take a moment and pray over your bride for communion. And that you will care for her and minister to her. Then after communion, what we're going to do is we're going to light the unity candle. The unity candle is right behind me. It symbolizes two lives now becoming one flesh. Let me read from the scriptures, and then I'll have you pray, Andrew. In the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 23, Paul wrote, "For I've received from the Lord that which I also deliver to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. When he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'Take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me.' In the same manner, he also took the cup after supper, saying, 'This cup is a new covenant in my blood. This do as often as you drink it, and do this in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death till he comes.'" So Andrew, would you hold Debbie's hand and please pray over her?
Great are your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing. Great are you, Lord. All the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will say, great are you, Lord. All the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will say, great are you, Lord. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise, we pour out our praise, it's your breath.
Andrew, God loves you, and he's blessed you abundantly. He's blessed you with Debbie. Debbie, she's kind. She's loving. She cares, empathetic. She's faithful, loyal. She's your bride. Amen. Debbie, God's blessed you with a very gracious man. He's a very, very loving man. He's a hard worker. He has the gift of hospitality that I know firsthand. And he's a man that fears and loves the Lord. God has blessed you. Before God, a man, you made your vows, exchanged rings, received communion, and promised to live together in love and devotion. Because of this, I take great pleasure in proclaiming you to be husband and wife. Andrew, you may kiss your wife. All right, please face your family and friends. Amen. We all love you and we rejoice with you. And ladies and gentlemen, it is my great pleasure to introduce for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Andrew Padilla.
Hey, my name's Hector Cortez, and I'm so happy to be here at Andrew and Debbie's wedding. And I just wanted to say that I wish them all the best in the world and all that they do. And I just really, really want to say that it's going to be a beautiful journey together. You guys made the best decision in your lives, and just so happy for you guys. And hopefully you guys could just enjoy all the blessings that God will give you, and just continue following your dreams, and wish you the best.
Hi, Debbie and Andrew. We thank you for allowing us to be here on your special day. We wish you happiness, love, and joy for the rest of you guys' lives. Thank you for this wonderful wedding that it is to be, to honor your special day. God bless you.
Andrew and Debbie, congratulations. I'm so happy for you guys. You guys are going to have an awesome, awesome life together. It's about time. God bless you guys. Bye.
Anybody else?
May Jesus bless your wonderful, wonderful union. God bless you both. We love you.
Andrew, Debbie, it's about time that you guys finally jumped over the broom. And, you know, Ron and myself were talking that we've been bugging you so much about, hey, you know what, get ahead and do it. So we're happy that you finally did it. And if it wasn't for that invite you gave me, I wouldn't have believed it. Anyway, God bless you guys.
Hi, Andrew and Debbie. Thank you very much for having us here. It was a real honor for both of us to be able to be here and celebrate this glorious day with you. We pray that you guys would be just prosperous in whatever the Lord has you lay your hand on, that you would be guided by Him and put Him first in everything that you do. Amen. And it just really was a blessing to be able to be here and to know you guys. It's been a real blessing, and we just pray that we'll get to know you guys better in the years to come, especially now with everything that's going on with Calvary Montclair, soon to be, I guess, Calvary Chapel Montclair. So anyway, thank you very much. It was a real blessing, and we really look forward to getting to know you guys better.
Same here. Thank you for inviting us. It was a real honor, a real treat for us to be here. We love it. Thank you.
Hello, Andrew, Debbie. We want to, it's Paul and Kathy here. We'd like to congratulate you on your ceremony today, and may God bless your marriage, your family, and I pray that you strive to grow old together.
Amen.
And keep God in the center of not only your lives, but your marriage and family as well. So we love you, and we're blessed to be here with you guys and celebrate this special day that God has set aside for you. And thank you once again. Have anything to say?
That's it. God bless you guys.
All right. God bless. Thanks.
Beautiful, beautiful wedding.
Thank you, David.
Hi, Andrew. Hi, Debbie. I just want to tell you, first of all, congratulations. And we want to, for Vivian and I, we want to thank you for just allowing us to be part of your great day. It was a great wedding. This is a great reception right now. And we just want to pray to the Lord that the Lord would just bless your wedding, bless your day, and especially bless your marriage. We want to thank you for allowing us to be part of your lives, and we look forward to the times that the Lord's going to continue to do a mighty work in your lives and in our friendships and everything that we do for the Lord. So, again, we just want to thank you for allowing us to be part of this. It's a great event. It's a great testimony to what the Lord has done to the both of you and what the Lord is going to do in the future. So, again, we just want to thank you for this time. And do all the, and give all the glory and all praise to our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Congratulations, Debbie and Andrew. This is a beautiful wedding. Everything is perfect. You guys are the perfect couple. Thank you for the privilege of being here. And like Edwin said, we look forward to see what the Lord's going to do in your life, in your marriage. And just thank you once again. It's an honor and a blessing to be here. Thank you.
Andrew, from the both of us, we thank you so much. It's been an honor and a pleasure to come to your wedding, and we
ask that the Lord would just bless you guys and continue to walk in His ways, and He will have that be that light to your path. We love you guys, and we're hoping the best for you, and you're such a neat couple. Right now we see what the Lord has already begun that good work in you guys, and we love you and praise you and give you all glory for what the Lord is doing.
And I agree with my husband. It's been a joy and a pleasure getting to know you guys, and looking forward to knowing you even more. And love you guys. God bless you. And congratulations.
Andrew and Debbie, we love you, and we're so thankful for you. And it was an absolute honor and privilege that you have given me to officiate your wedding. It was a blessing in every way, and you guys are wonderful, and looking forward to many more years of connecting with you, ministering side by side with you, and let's serve the Lord together. Let's see what He has, and we'll be praying for your marriage, and I just love you guys, and so thankful for you guys. God bless you.
I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. I feel it. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. If tonight's the night, let's live it up. I got my money, let's spin it up. Go out and smash it. Like, oh my God, jump out that sofa, let's kick it off.
Oh, morena, ¿cómo está tu cuco? Estamos en Cuculandia. Qué lindo es tu cucu, tan bello tu cucu, redondito y suavecito. Qué lindo es tu cucu, cuando te pones pantalón y te toca por detrás, se me suelta el corazón. Y te quiero más y más, 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 no me canso de mirar, pero quisiera tocar. Ándate, no seas malita, yo quiero una tocadita, ita, ita. Qué lindo es tu cucu, bonito tu cucu, redondito y suavecito, responsable está tu cucu, cucu, yeah.
No te metas con mi cucu, porque te doy una cachetada.
Oh, cachete se me pone colorada, colorada.
Mi cucu. Si me pongo pantalones y me golpeo de
just an oldie but good.